today we're going to be using Adobe Illustrator to make some neat digital art very easily indeed. Welcome back to Satori Graphics, everybody, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. For today's digital art tutorial, you're first going to need an image, of course, and I got mine from Pixabay, which is actually linked down in the description below. It's a place to get royalty-free stock images, and it's a really useful resource that I always use. We want the canvas in Illustrator to actually fit around the image perfectly, and to do this, you simply need to head up to Object, Artboards, and then find the Fit to Bounds option. Then go ahead and lock down your image so it doesn't move around throughout today's tutorial. Today I'm going to show you some techniques that I use to make my digital art. And the idea here today, guys, is that you can use the very same techniques to be creative and to make your very own digital art. The ellipse tool can be used to make a circle, and the first major technique in today's video is to utilize the transparency panel. In fact, this is the main component of today's video on making digital art. In the transparency panel, we're going to play with the blend modes, which will change the effects of shapes on your design. If you build up layers using various different blend modes, then you can make some very interesting designs for sure. I personally like to use overlay and soft light as the main blend modes for the digital art in this style today. So for example, I could copy this circle with Command or Control C and then paste it right over the top with Command or Control F. Now I have two different objects with blend modes, and you can still kind of see behind them on the actual image itself. Another neat effect is to add a gradient to the shape whilst the blend mode is still activated. Again, play around with this technique and just get creative with it. I find that lowering and adjusting the opacity of the gradient sliders can also be a good way to make some neat designs. And to do that, simply click one side of the gradient and then change the opacity values. So I'm going to copy this layer again and paste a third circle over the top. It's all about being creative and expanding upon your original image using these skills and these techniques. Another technique that you might want to use for this style of digital art is applying a drop shadow to a shape or an aspect of your design. I feel that adding a very subtle shadow in the right way can look awesome. And to do that, simply head into the stylize options here and play around with the settings, having the preview box checked the entire time. For this kind of design work, you might want to set up an RGB document rather than cmyk, especially if you're going to use things like drop shadows. This is because the blends of shadows work a lot better in Illustrator if the document is RGB. As your digital art design becomes more complex, it would be a good idea to use the layers window. This is much like the layer stack in Photoshop, but it helps you in Illustrator because you can locate, lock, unlock, and edit specific layers easily. The blue square icon on the right that you can see here lets us know which layer is actually currently selected. If you want to lock a layer, just come over to here and click the lock icon. Now for one of the best techniques for my digital artwork, and that is to utilize the mesh tool. So I will go ahead and duplicate another shape, and then proceed to add a mesh over the circle with the mesh tool. Once that's added, click to create some mesh lines. Then you can see when I press I for the eyedropper tool and sample colors from the image itself, I can then press U to revert back to the mesh tool and select a different section. Repeating this process over and over is really neat on this kind of design because the blend mode is not normal and the shapes below it too are somewhat transparent. so you end up with a really cool effect over the top of your image. You should just play around with this effect and spend some time perfecting it. I really like this relaxed and experimental style of digital art in Adobe Illustrator. And as you can see, my design is advancing onwards, and I have one more effect for you to use. I have a large circle here with a blend mode of overlay and a gradient fill. I also have a rectangle around the artboard, which I can select in combination with the shape by holding down Shift. Then control or right click and make a clipping mask. This will leave the area on the canvas itself, which just keeps everything neat and tidy, as well as looking really cool. So by using all of today's techniques that I've spoken about and taking your time to be creative, you can end up with a digital design just like mine here. I've also added a solid color overlay, which you can see. But what do you guys think? Does it look better with or without? I think it needs to be there in my design, but maybe in a lower opacity, because I do want a soft and kind of cold style for this design. Oh yeah, by the way, in the layers panel, things can get quite hectic, so it's always a good idea to double click the name of your layer and then rename it so you can keep track of everything. Oh, and lastly, of course, I added some typography in a kind of neat and subtle manner. For some reason, I thought Chinese script would look good here. So I found the Chinese word for peace, and I'm not sure if it's correct, but I think it is. So yeah, there's my digital artwork in today's video, made easy. Remember to take your time to get creative with all of these techniques that I've shown you today, and make something cool. If you want to boost your awareness and your skills as a graphic designer, subscribe to Satori Graphics for weekly graphic design uploads. And if you do make a cool design with these skills, remember to tag me on Instagram or Twitter with your designs. Like and share my content on social media if you want to help out my channel. And if you do have a question or you want to start talking to me about something specific, check the link in the description below and head over to my worthy.ta account, where you can give me a small fee for my time helping you with your problems. Until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.